In this example, we've got some phone records of a PDF, and all we're interested in, you'll notice there's some here fax to EM. We just want to know the fax calls. But you'll notice we've got words in here, there's lots of spaces, etc. So we could try various text to column type tools. So let's try delimited. So let's try a space. So you'll notice that looks okay until you hit over there where suddenly dates are not working out, not in the correct places. Let's maybe try fixed width. So again, we can try and do some of these. Let's see. But then you'll see there's some problems there. So it doesn't look like the tool can handle it. So what we now need to do is come up with a formula that'll figure out, firstly, which of these are fax calls, and secondly, just to pull out the cost right at the end, the last number, which seems to always be after a space. So the first thing I'm going to do is just try and figure out which of these apply, which have got the fax to M in it. So we're going to look for this word fax to M. So I'm going to make use of the search function. The reason I'm going to rather use search than find is because I'm worried that occasionally this may come in uppercase or lowercase. So we're going to say find the text, and I'm going to type fax to EM. Where must it look for it? In here. And we say OK. And I'll copy that down. You'll notice I get an error message when it's not there, but if it finds it, it gives me a number. So that's useful. Although that's useful, value and any error messages do give problems in Excel. So what we're going to do is we're going to add to this formula. There's a function in Excel called isError. And all that will do is tell me if there's an error or not. So if I copy and paste down, you'll see wherever there's a true, it looks like it's some sort of a call. Wherever there's a false, there's a fax to EM. So therefore, I can now build an if function around it. So I'm going to say if all of that equals true, then I'm going to say that's a call, otherwise it's a fax. When I copy and paste it down, we've got what's a call and what's a fax. The next thing we need to do now is work out where the last space is, because that seems to be where the mount is. So to do that, first we're going to make use of our len function to work out how long that cell is. And if I removed all the spaces, so to do that, we're going to use substitute. And I'm going to say, go look at that text there. The old text is inverted comma, space, inverted comma. New text is two inverted commas next to each other. It would give me that. And I'm going to now just put a len around it to work out how many characters it is without the spaces. The net result must be that that number of characters minus that number of characters must be the number of spaces. I can copy that down. Now we need to extract the space. So I'm going to build this formula up. So the first thing I'm going to do is replace the last space over here with some unique character. So I'm going to make use of substitute. I'm going to say, look at that text there. The old text is a space. The new text, I'm just going to put a straight up line. But what instance number of the space? I'm going to say, look over here. When I say OK, you'll see we've now got this, but now we've got a unique character at this point. So what I'm now going to do is build around it. I'm going to use my find function, and I'm going to say find this unique character in this text. And we don't have to worry about the start number because it's unique. You'll see it tells me it's character 47. So we now know the space is in character 47. I'm going to use a mid function. The text is over here. A it must start at whatever number we find here. I'm going to plus 1. And how many? I'm going to just make it a big number, 100. You'll see it brings through the number, but for some reason, let's just copy it down. You'll notice that it's not adding up, so we have a problem that's not been seen as text. So what we're going to now do is wrap a value function all the way around that. Copy and paste it down. And now you'll see it's adding up.